I remember you guys.
Thank you.
Ready?
I think we're ready.
Okay. All right, let's go.
All right. Well, hello, everyone. We are so glad that you all are here today for our first, this is like our first session of this training. We love the title called, I Have PBIS Rewards, Now What? And today we're going to actually really focus on the rewarding aspect of PBIS Rewards. So we are so glad that you are here today. We want to thank you for introducing yourselves by putting where you're from in the chat box. If you haven't done that yet, feel free to do so. And if you also want to add what school or organization that you're representing today, we'd love to see that too. So shout out to everyone that's already done that and those of you that are about to do that, but feel free to introduce yourself in the chat box. And so since you all have had an opportunity to tell us a little bit more about yourself, where you're from, and maybe you added your school or organization, we want to introduce ourselves to you too. The great thing is, I feel like a lot of you all, we've already met before. Some of these faces, hi, look so familiar, and names as well. So we're so glad if this is, you know, your first time here, welcome. If it's, you know, your 25th time here, we're so glad to have you again. So you might already know us. My name is India Williams, and I'm one of the professional development educators here at PBIS Rewards. I'm actually here in Evansville, Indiana. So Bill, like I said, love that you're representing Indiana as well. And our home office is here in Evansville, Indiana as well. I have, you know, I think it's 25 plus years now in education, but I'm so excited to have this opportunity to be a trainer with PBIS Rewards. And one of the things I love the most about particularly this role is the person that I get to work with the most, and that's Miss Anna Michaels.
Good morning, everybody. Yes, I'm so happy to see so many familiar faces and names. We're glad that you're here today. Same thing, I have 20 years in education and so excited to be with PBIS Rewards now, coming out of public school as a teacher of sixth graders and then also an administrator at a fifth and sixth campus and then a kinder through fourth grade campus. So, but we're happy to see you all here. We even have somebody here from the Virgin Islands today, so we can all be jealous of her and what they have going on down there in the Virgin Islands, even though I can't be too jealous because I'm in Fort Worth, Texas. It's supposed to be almost 70 degrees here today. You know, it was 40 yesterday, 70 today, you know, it's always fun. So, but we're ready to get started today.
Absolutely. Let's get right to it. So with you all being the PBIS experts that you are, you already know how important it is to make sure that we do kind of talk about the expectations for today's training until we get all the way into it, or should I say before we get all the way into it. So, you know, we try to keep it simple. We're just going to try to be respectful, be responsible, and be safe today by exhibiting such behaviors as muting your microphone when you're not sharing, being open to new ideas, sharing your relevant ideas, whether you want to share them by unmuting and sharing them verbally with the group, or even if you want to put them in the chat. We also want to make sure that you do stay engaged. If you want to put your camera on today, we have a smaller group, so we'd love to see your smiling faces. Or if you'd also like to utilize those nonverbal feedback icons, we love that too. So if you want to put up a heart because you heard something you love, you go right for it, okay? Also, if you want to just even turn your cameras on, give us thumbs up. Anything you'd like today to just stay engaged, we encourage that. But probably the most important thing we want to make sure that we encourage regarding expectations is please do not be afraid to ask questions. And in fact, you don't have to wait until the very end to ask those questions. Feel free to put any questions, any concerns, any wonderings that you have in the chat box. And you can do that throughout today's training. You don't have to wait to the end. So whether you call it the parking lot, the discussion board, or the chat box, feel free to put those questions, concerns, and wonderings in there throughout our entire training. So we also want to make sure that we go over today's agenda, all right? We'll make sure you're at the right session that you want to be in. So today's session is the I Have PBIS Rewards, Now What? Well, we're going to focus particularly on rewarding. So we're going to look at what are some rewarding best practices. We're also going to look at how can you utilize the PBIS reward system to do rewarding and acknowledging of students. We're also going to talk about how you use the groups page to really make rewarding students easy within the system. And then, of course, we're going to give you an opportunity to get live into the PBIS reward system with Anna today. And then we are going to have a wrap up that's going to include kind of what are some of our favorite features, tips, and tricks for PBIS rewards rewarding. And then also, what are some upcoming professional developments that'll be offered? We also want to give you a personal invitation to our Facebook user group, and we'll also have an opportunity for you to take a survey to let us know what we did well and what we could do better. So we absolutely love this little cartoon here. And this teacher's saying, I like how Bonnie's not stepping on my last nerve. Well, we've all probably been there sometime in our career, yet we want to show you how rewarding and particularly rewarding students for their positive behavior with the PBIS reward system can help you not have to say thank you for stepping on my last nerve. In fact, we're hoping that it won't get you to the point where you only have one nerve left. So now we're going to start looking at what are some rewarding best practices, just in general. And really the main thing we want to start off with is why should we even reward students anyway? You know, when I was first teaching, you know, it was kind of like, I'm not going to reward you for what you're supposed to be doing anyway. Okay, you're supposed to be on time. You're supposed to be doing your best. You're supposed to be kind. I'm not going to reward you for that. You know, yet as I got more into teaching and more into, you know, the whys behind what we do and how to do those things better, I really realized that acknowledging students is important. I feel good when I'm acknowledged. I feel great when I get my paycheck to show that I did a job well done. I love when I go to Chick-fil-A and they have their reward system and I get free brownies because I've been a great customer. So that really helped me understand the importance of making sure that we do reward and acknowledge our students for all of the positive behavior that they exhibit and the great choices that they make. But why should we reward? What are some specific reasons? One in particular is that when we reward students, it really actively teaches them what behaviors are expected of them. They're like, okay, when I do this, I don't get that award. I don't get that acknowledgement. But when I do that, wow, all my teachers are acknowledging me. It feels so great. So we're actually teaching them through the acknowledgement or rewarding what behaviors are expected of them in that campus environment. Another reason is that, you know, when we do acknowledge the students and reward them, it really does increase the likelihood that they're going to continue to engage in that appropriate behavior. We know how good it feels to get that free brownie at Chick-fil-A. And so we know, since we understand that feeling, we can understand how students will say, hey, I really like being acknowledged for good things. I think I'm going to keep on doing good things. So that's what rewarding can do, is really increase that likelihood of them continuing to engage in the appropriate behavior. Another reason? Well, it's really to increase the opportunities to build positive adult-student relationships. Unfortunately, a lot of our students have not had some of them just haven't had a whole lot of positive engagement with adults in their family, their neighborhoods, whatever. But when we do acknowledge them for good behavior, when we do reward them, it truly does just increase and grow the positive adult-student relationships that can happen, okay? So that's just another benefit of rewarding. Another thing that it does, you know, if you've been working with PBIS for a while, you know how PBIS and social emotional learning go hand in hand. And so what happens when we're rewarding and acknowledging these students, it really encourages them to demonstrate positive social emotional skills and behaviors as well. And then finally, when we acknowledge and reward our students, it really does help make a positive school climate and culture. And all of us want that, right? So these are just a few reasons why it's really important for us to make sure that we are rewarding and acknowledging our students for all of the positive choices and behaviors that they exhibit within the campus environment. Hold on, Anna, you gotta unmute.
I forgot, sorry. Knew somebody was gonna do it today. So next we really wanna talk about this rewarding ratio. This has a lot of research behind it and looking at the number of positive interactions we have compared with negative interactions. And really this is not something that only applies to our students at school. This really works for all relationships, whether that is your significant other or your children at home. This is really a great ratio to utilize when we think about our interactions with others. Now, of course, today we're really gonna focus on students, but if you are an administrator at your campus or you're in a leadership role, also think about those staff interactions that you have, that we really want to have this same ratio where we have those positive interactions with them. We found a really great quote that kind of goes along with this, that the single most important thing a teacher can do to improve overall behaviors of students in their classroom is to increase the number of positive interactions they have with each student. And we know that the parents, they're not keeping their best at home. They're sending them to school, whether that's through face-to-face or that's to virtual school. We know this is their baby and they love them. And every child has redeeming qualities. And so sometimes we have to search a little bit deeper for some of those with our friends, but they are there. And we really have to utilize those and celebrate those as well. So for some of our students, it is going to be more of a challenge to hit this ratio with them. And so we want to give you a couple of ideas on how do you meet this ratio with students. So, you can show interest, find something that student is interested in and ask them questions about that. And that really causes that interaction to be positive and to get that conversation going. Next is be affectionate. Now we know with COVID, this is definitely a challenge, but if you are in the hybrid setting or you are in a face-to-face setting, we know that we can give an elbow bump or we can give a fist bump. We even have seen some pens that have a hand on the end and you could give a little virtual high five with your pen, or you could do the same thing in a Zoom room. You could give a high five using that reaction button and kind of make those connections in the same way. Next one is to show appreciation. Sometimes it's finding the smallest thing that student is doing and really celebrating it. So thanks for coming to class on time. Thanks for turning your camera on. Thank you for walking in the hallway. Thanks for being here today. Thanks for picking up that one piece of trash. Any of those small things just to recognize that student and get that ball rolling in a positive manner. Next is just be curious. Ask your students about things. Hey, I noticed you got a haircut. Are those new shoes that you have on today? Is that a new shirt that you have on? I see that you have a dog in the background. Is that your pet? We know our students love to share those things about themselves personally. And so being curious about those, again, really gets those conversations going. And finally, just being playful with our students. Sometimes we need reminders that we don't have to be so set and focused on our academic goals, that we also have to have fun with our kids. So those are a couple of ways to really help maybe share with some staff members that may find it challenging to meet this 5-to-1 ratio, but it really gets that ball rolling when it comes to having the positive interaction. We also do want to remember, we don't want to focus on students that are receiving that negative attention. So if they're doing something in a negative way, that's not when we want to have that interaction with them. We don't want to reward that. And we also don't want to interrupt our instruction. We know there are times that we need to be focused on that instruction. And so it's sometimes easy to weave it in as you're going, those positive interactions, but certainly being careful about those negative interactions, how those occur. So hopefully that helps with some of those rewarding ratios.
Absolutely. I love that, Anna. And another, you know, just kind of best practice to remember is to always include behavior specific praise when you are acknowledging and rewarding your students. Okay. And in fact, we're going to even show you a little later how you can even still include behavior specific praise as part of giving your points to your students within the PBIS Rewards system. But first, let's think about exactly what behavior-specific praise needs to include. We believe here at PBIS Rewards it needs to have two very important elements. The first is you definitely want to let the student know what positive behavior that you observed. And then secondly, you want to tell the student how observing that behavior made you feel. Okay, so for example, let's just say in a virtual learning environment, you have a student, Keisha. Keisha never has her camera on. And it is an expectation of your school that the students stay engaged by having their cameras on. She never has it on. But for today, for whatever reason, she had her camera on the entire learning session. So this would be a wonderful opportunity for you to give Keisha behavior-specific praise. Whether you actually said it aloud within the virtual lesson, or you could actually private message her through the chat box, but you could say, Keisha, I noticed that you had your camera on throughout today's entire session. Thank you for doing that. It made me feel so proud and respected when you had your camera on the entire time. Then you could follow up with, may I give you some points for that? And then you could actually give her some points through the PBIS reward system. But we just want to make sure to encourage you to do both of those elements. Tell them what you saw that was positive, and then also tell them how seeing that made you feel. And we do want to just be honest with you. You may not initially get the feedback that you anticipate because some students just are not comfortable with behavior-specific praise. Maybe they're in a situation in their home or within their family or neighborhood where they don't get complimented a lot, where they don't get acknowledged for their positive choices. So it may feel a little uncomfortable to them at first, but don't worry, just keep giving that behavior-specific praise. Keep being honest with it. Keep being consistent with it. And then the more that they get that behavior-specific praise, the more comfortable they're going to feel with it. And then the next thing you know, they're going to be using behavior-specific praise with other people within the school and maybe even outside of the school. So if they're not comfortable with it, don't give up. Keep up giving behavior-specific praise to your students when you see them doing the right things. And we know for some people, it's maybe those I feel words just don't come naturally. So guess what? We've done the hard work for you. We saw in the chat box, someone said, hey, are we recording today's session? Absolutely, we are recording it. So you don't have to feel like you've got to write all these I feel simple words down in a flurry or take pictures. We will be sending you a resource link as well and the recording. And in that resource link, you're going to see a document that has all these I feel words right there for you. So you don't have to think about, oh, what word should I say? Is it appropriate for the group I'm working with? Here's some great examples that works for primary and elementary students, such as happy, good, glad, energetic, respected. And then there's some other words that are more appropriate for older students like middle and high school, where you could say hardworking, appreciated, valuable. So we've done the hard work for you. We've even given you sample I feel words that you can use to make sure that your behavior specific praise statements say exactly what you want to say about how what you saw made you feel.
So next, we really want to talk about making those connections between when you are rewarding those points to students using the PBIS reward system and your matrix that you have at your school. So for ours, you can see our general ideas here and our expectations are being respectful, being responsible, and being safe. So just going back and making that connection to our matrix when we give out those points is a really great idea. So if we first think about a student that comes back from the bathroom really quickly, we know sometimes when we send someone to the bathroom, they are there forever. And so when somebody comes back quickly, they use a restroom and they're coming right back to class, we really are happy about that because they're not missing that instructional time. So going back to our matrix then, thinking about how do we make that connection? So that for the restroom is returning to class promptly, following that expectation perfectly. And so we're going to give behavior specific praise for that. and we're going to make it tie specifically to being responsible. And so utilizing that verbiage when we give that behavior specific praise is a great way to make those connections. Thank you for being responsible by coming back to class so quickly so you didn't miss anything. I really feel proud when I see you back in class and not wasting time at the restroom. So a great example. When we are talking about maybe our students in the remote setting, so if you see that last column on the right side, we added a column just for virtual learning to our existing matrix. This is a great way if you're in a hybrid setting, so you have both in-person and virtual learning going on. If we have a student that reports bullying in the comments in a break room, we're going to make that connection here in the remote part of our matrix, that is seeing that second bullet there. I know it may be really small for you, reporting that unsafe or bullying comments to the teacher. So that's keeping us updated. So then we are going to give that, again, behavior specific praise. And if we can't do that, maybe out loud to that student, because that's not something that we're going to share with everybody, then that might be something that you also could put in the comments when you give that behavior specific praise. And we'll share that again, how to include that comment. And then students can see those comments when they log in to their web portal or when they log into the student app, they can read that. So, and then just making again that comment about and tying it in with bringing that safety back. So that online safety, we're really including that with our behavior specific praise. So if you're attending this training and you're going to train other people in your on your staff, this is a good way to personalize this to your staff, to your school, and really making the connection between our expectations. So we're using that common language again and again. It's reinforcing that with our staff and our students. And then also giving those points to our students when they show those expectations and really rewarding them for those things, making all those connections.
Well, and I also want to give a shout out to Tamika. Tamika's behavior-specific praise thing down, okay? She even gave you some examples in the chat box. We love it. Thank you so much, Tamika, for sharing that, putting it in the chat. She's got it down. But that's, you know, a lot of times we have people saying, well, we don't know what do we give them points for? Go back to your matrix and literally just whatever the matrix says they should be doing when you see them do that. That's what you give them maybe behavior specific praise for. That's what you give them points for. Okay. And don't worry. I know some people may be saying we don't have a matrix. Well, we got you covered. And that same resource link we're going to give you later, the example matrix we just used, you'll have access to that where you can download that one. We also have some other sample matrices that you can look at, you can download. And then we also have a blank one as well that you can download and make your own. So no worries if you don't have a matrix, we got you covered with this Bitly resource link that we're gonna give you toward the end of today's session, okay? But right now what we wanna do is we wanna get into looking at how you can use PBIS rewards to really make rewarding your students simple and easy. So Anna in a little bit is going to actually go into the system live and show you what these steps look like. But one thing we always say is some things are so nice, you want to see them twice. So let's first right now just look at what those steps are to use the web portal for PBIS Rewards in order to give points to your students. So the first step is you're going to log into the web portal for staff and you're going to click on the main menu where it says reward. That page is also your home page. So usually when you log in, that's the first page you're going to see. The second step is you're going to type in the name of the student and it should automatically populate for you. The next step then is you need to decide what points you want to give the student or point and which expectation you want that point to be aligned with. So that's where your matrix really comes into play. So if your matrix pieces are be respectful, be responsible, be safe, make sure that when your admin is setting up PBIS rewards for you, that they use those same expectations within the system so that you can make sure that if a student's being responsible, you give them points in the responsible area. Because every time you do this, PBIS rewards is actually getting data for you in those expectations. So if all of your teachers are given a lot of points in respect, you'll be able to see data that shows that. And you can say, oh, we're doing great with respect. But if you notice there's not a whole lot of safety points being given out, that lets your campus know we might want to, you know, maybe do some reteaching or some lessons around safety, because maybe that's an area that the students need some more reinforcement with. So you decide which point or points you want to give the students, how many, and with each expectation. Once you click that, here's where your behavior specific praise can come into play with the PBIS reward system. You have the option to give a comment, okay? You don't have to, but you can. Now, this is a setting that admin can turn on or off. So if you haven't seen the comments, it's because your admin did not turn that on in the settings. But even with comments there, you don't have to, that's optional. But this is where you could put that behavior specific praise. Thank you, Blake, for being responsible and letting us know. That made me feel proud. So you could put that in the comments box. And then you simply click the reward button. So it's literally that easy to give points right from the first page you see when you get into the web portal for PBIS Rewards. Now, even in my opinion, an even easier way is to utilize the app, okay? So I say it's easier because you have a whole lot more options as far as how to select the student or students you want to give points to. In the web portal, you have to type in their name in the search area, but with the app, you can do the same thing by typing in their name, or you can scan a student badge, and you can scan a QR code that can be generated from a PDF that you can print off from a group page within the web portal. And Anna's going to show you all of this live in the system. But let's take a little quick peek at what it looks like in the app. So you're going to open up the app. You're at this home page. You click on recognize a student. You choose the area you want to put the points in. You can include a comment if you want. Mia followed instructions. Then you're going to type in the student's name in the search area. Select the student. Boom, point is given. Another way is you can select your points, hit scan to reward, and scan a badge. Boom, the points are awarded. And a third way, you select the points, put a comment if you want, click scan to reward again, but this time you can actually scan QR codes that are on a PDF that you can print off from the web portal for one of your classes or groups. With that, you can give points to some of the students. You can give points to all of the students in that group, literally one click. And no worries, like we said, we're gonna go over definitely how to do these things in the web portal. And you will have this recording later if you wanna go over and look at any of these things again later on after today's session.
We know that there are so many people that you are working with your students virtually. And rewarding students virtually can sometimes really be a challenge as we try to pivot from what we've known for so long. So we really wanted to come up with a list of ways to give those points out when you work with our students that are working from home. So this list is long, and I'm just going to highlight a couple of our favorites that are on here. And so when students and teachers are utilizing that check-in system, now we are offering that with our social emotional learning for staff to check in with our students. And we have just rolled out to a student self SEL check where students can check in. So when they do that, that's a great way to reward points. When students are working independently, we know that's one of the biggest challenges that is out there is just getting that work done. And so when students do that, making sure to give them those points. When they're working cooperatively, whether that's in a break room virtually, or if they're working in class even, or you have a hybrid situation, giving them those points. And then some of those same things that we enjoy doing in the face-to-face classroom, like our spirit days, you still reward points for that in the virtual environment. Being in Texas and India is in Indiana and the rest of our company is, and we're working virtually, we do that ourselves. We gave ourselves points the other day because we all had a pajama day, pants day. So that's something that adults enjoy as well. So there's lots of other ideas here for you to kind of pick and choose, or this may be a great list to take to your staff members or to your department, and it may be some idea sparks that can really get the conversation going. So we know that it is rough out there when we are working with students virtually. And so I especially love this picture of Christy Teigen when someone asks how distance learning is going with her face. So we really wanted to come up with a list that matches and kind of aligns some of those biggest concerns of our students when they are working virtually, and then how you can best utilize PBIS rewards to reward those points. And then one step further, how could you redeem those points for students? So we know that's an upcoming session that we're going to do, but we do have this on one sheet of paper. And so it's a PDF that you can download. And so we took those virtual behavior concerns, and then, like we said, matched that up with if we have students not doing their work, then how can we specifically tie in rewarding points to that? So you can see giving points each time they have that assignment turned in. And then how can we redeem points and also encouraging that same behavior to be done again and again? So maybe we're going to look at some virtual learning tools or virtual field trips. So interactive activities with students that encourage them to be present with us. So you can see it's making a tie back to getting those behaviors that we are really looking for with our students. So this is a great resource that will also be included. And Andy also put it in the chat for you. You can just download it right now if you want it. So a great one for you.
I love that. Thank you, Anna. And so we're getting ready in a few moments to get live into the system to see some of the things we've talked about how really simple it is for you to use PBIS rewards to help you with this rewarding and acknowledging of your students. When we do these trainings, if you had any of them with Anna and myself before, one thing we always say is, if you want to stay in the loop, stay in the groups, okay? Groups page is where it's at. Okay, it's kind of home base. It's the happening area, especially within the web portal, but also in the app of where you can kind of live and do everything you need to do to not only reward your students, but you'll find out later on in some of our other sessions that you can redeem the points they've earned. You can message families. You can do all kind of stuff from the groups page. But today we're going to highlight some of the things that really work well for rewarding your students. First of all, do you notice that red circle right there around that number? That is the points balance that the student in that group or that class has for the moment, okay? So that's the points they take with them. That's their balance. That's how many points they have to spend in any of the school store, the My Store, any of that. That's how many points they have earned so far that they can still spend. Now, if you have the system and you're like, I don't see those numbers on my kids' cards, it could be that your admin has turned that off in the settings. So if your school doesn't want those balances to show, then you can turn that off. But if your school is fine with that, you can see the point balance, and the students can too if you decide to share it with them, have it up on your screen, whatever. They can see how many points they do have currently that they can spend on things in the store, events, and raffles. So that's really helpful to see that right there. The other thing you can do right here from that group or that class is you can reward points. So once again, there's those areas that match the expectations. You would simply click, if you want to give all the kids a respect point, because everybody's being respectful, you could click on that select all students. Then you can decide, I want to give everybody respect points. So click on respect. If you wanted to include a comment, you could actually click on the include comment box and say, everybody's being so respectful in class today by listening. And then you simply, you hit the reward button, and every single student with that one reward click gets a point for respect, okay? You could also just click one student's card or two or three and give those students or that one student points as well. So it's great to be able to reward and acknowledge the students right in the group page that matches the group you're working with at that time. Another cool function that Anna and I both love is the random button. This is great too, because it's another way that you can fairly and equitably acknowledge students. Let's say that everybody thinks it's a reward to go down to the office. What you can do is basically click that select all button again and click on random. and PBIS Rewards will choose for you the student that's going to go down to the office. So they won't say, you always choose Brooke. Yeah, that's your favorite. Nope, let us be the bad guy. We can choose who can, you know, receive that reward of being able to take the note down to the office with the random button. It's also great because it can help you put kids into equitable groups, pick partners. It's just really a great way to acknowledge your students in a fair way to be able to be in the groups as well as to do activities for you without feeling the pressure of who do I choose or using that old school can with their names on popsicle sticks. And another cool button is the toggle presence. Okay, like I said before, you can acknowledge students all at the same time. You can give the whole group a point or points all with one click. But sometimes you have students that aren't there. And remember, points aren't given, they are earned. And so if a student is not there that day or at that time, it's not fair for them to get points that they didn't earn. So what you can do is click on that student's card and then click on toggle presence. It then will show that they are not with the group at that time. So when you do give points to the whole group, that person would not get them because they weren't there to earn them. So it's kind of a way to show you whether or not that student was there and to keep giving points as a group equitable. And then let's say they come back before your session is over, you simply click on their name again and click on toggle presence again. And then it shows that they're back with the group and they can earn group points as well. So it's just a cool way to make sure that when you are giving group points, they're given equitably. And so another thing, remember when we were looking at the app and we showed you where you could print off that PDF form with the QR codes on it? These are the steps of how you would do that. So within that group, you would click on the settings kind of cogwheel right there. And then you would choose group print. Then you can decide how you want their cards to be distributed onto the page you want to print. And then after that, boom, your PDF is created. And each student in that group has their own specific QR code that you could scan with the app to give them points. And do you see that QR code in the upper left? If you click on that one, if you scan that one, it gives all the students the points at the same time. So this is great, especially when you're teaching in the virtual environment. You can just have that paper right there next to you for that group. And while you're teaching and instructing, use your phone or your other smart device and just scan points while you're teaching. So that way you don't miss a beat. If you are face-to-face and you're doing, you know, field trips or anything like that, this is great too, because you can keep it with you and you can just scan it like that so kids don't have to have their badges with them and lose them if you're going someplace. So this is just a very handy, easy to print off item that truly makes giving points and rewarding students easy and simple. So let's look at how groups can work on the app. You know, you can use the app to reward just one student, a couple of students, or a whole group by using the groups feature in the app. You can reward all the students, or you can also use that random button we were talking about too. So let's take a look. So you open it, you're gonna click on groups, choose the group you want to work with, select the points that go with the right expectations. If you wanna give a comment, you can click on include comment and type it in. You know, great teamwork. And what I could do is I could click on that select all button if I wanted, or just a few names. So maybe I just want to give it to three kids in the class, click reward, boom, they got the points. But if I did want to give it to the whole group, I would just click on that select all, click on reward, boom. Everybody that easily has that point in the whole group. Now, another thing that I can do here is if I click on that select all again and click on random, there's my one person to go to the office. Or she could be my first person in the group, do it again, there's my second person in the group. Do it again, there's my third person in the group, okay? Do it again, fourth. I could keep going and going and going to create small groups with the group feature in the app, or to pick winners for something that I'm doing. But it just makes rewarding and acknowledging students very simple to do, not just on the web portal, but also on the app when you're using the group feature.
All right, so I am going to get us into the system quickly and show you those couple of things, what it looks like. Let me move it over here. So just as India talked about, There we go. So just as India talked about, this very first page that you come to is the reward screen, and you can search for a student here. This screen is really great. Oh, I forgot about this school. This screen is really great, especially if you don't have a homeroom class that's assigned to you. Maybe you're a counselor, or you provide specific interventions to students, or you're an administrator. Then this is a great place for you. I can select a student here, and then I can also select their points. So you can see our points do have different ways that they can be set up. They can be set up like this, where you can decide 1 through 3 for the point value, or you can just have it 1 point per expectation, or it can be 1 through 10. Those are our three different settings that are available for admin. So you can see this school is set up with the 1 through 3. So if I want to give 3 points for respect, I can always type a comment here. And then I simply can come down here to the bottom and click reward. And it just gives me a little update about how my student is doing as far as their points. So that's that very first page. But like we said, most people are going to be in this groups tab. It's going to be their home base that they're in most of the day. And so those students that are assigned to you because you are their classroom teacher, those students are going to appear here. If there are other specific groups that I want to be able to see easily, you can see I just selected these orange stars up here at the top, and this makes it come up here to be one of my favorites. So this is really important, especially if you're using your phone, because then these are the groups that are going to appear on my phone. Your phone cannot pull all the groups from your whole school, it'll be too many. But if you are here in the web portal and you wanna see all the groups for your school, I'm gonna click this little down arrow here, and all of these groups that are here for my entire school, again, I can just click this magical math class, and that class again will come up and it will be one of my favorites here. If I want to create a group, maybe I have a new after school club, all I have to do is select this green button here to create a new group. And I can call it a runner's club and select the subject, which is other for me. And I'll click save. And the system will bring me to a page that is almost, it's like a blank group. So I can click here to add my students, or I could change the name if I want to. And all I have to do is start typing in my students' names and clicking them, and they are going to be members of that group now. So really easy to create your own group if you would like to do that. I'm gonna click the save button. I think I'll go back out to a group that's a little bit bigger than just one person. So let me go to this one right here. And so this is going to be one that's assigned to me. And so like India said, we can see each of my students have different numbers of points. So, and this can be good sometimes, but sometimes it is competitive among students, so it can be turned off if that is a problem. We can select all of our students and give them points very easily. I just clicked on this button that did say select all students, decide I wanna give them three respect and 2 responsibility. I can include that comment if I want to do that for everybody, and I'm going to click reward and go ahead and give out those points to everyone in that class. My other option too is if I have a student like Ashley that she's not here today, then I can click on her card and go to toggle presence. And so now you can see her card is kind of grayed out and it says not present. So if I were to select all my students again and we had 3 points because we did great during a fire drill, then I would click reward 3 and she would not receive those points. So all of those are going to be options here on the groups page. This random button, if I want to select a student, I would just select all. And let's say I'm gonna get Ashley back here. There we go. Oh, now all my students are not active. Hold on. Oh my goodness. Let me get them back in class. Hold on. Sorry. Let's actually have class today. So if I want to select all my students and click random, then I can pick my winner from that. So, and just like India said, if I click random again, then I can say, okay, these two, Alicia and Xavier, y'all are going to be partners together. Or those are my two winners. So those are options for you there that we really love. So, and then the last thing we just want to show you is here in the settings, this is how you get to that PDF. I'm going to go to group print and then see how many I want on a page. And it's going to bring it up here as a PDF. And if you are not virtual, if you're face-to-face, this is a great one to hang up near your door. Or if you are going someplace, this is great. If your students don't have badges with them, you can scan them easily. Or someone can give all of your students points by scanning this QR code at the very top. This is a really handy one to have. So that is a really easy one to print out and have right there next to you on your desk if you're working with your students virtually. Okay, so I am going to switch us back. And we are going to give you a couple of our favorite tips and tricks to finish out today. So we just want to give you a little bit of information just about economy. When you are talking about giving out points to students when they earn them, why is that economy so important? If we have one teacher that's giving too few points and one teacher that's giving too many points, how does that cause an issue then with our other things that we have for our school, our store, our events, our raffles, and also our relationships with our students and between our staff members? So there is a way in the PBIS reward system to really help kind of equalize that and set some goals. And that is here through our daily point goals. So the way that this can be accessed is through someone that has admin rights. They're going to go to the settings and then they're going to come down to this one that says daily point goals. It looks like a bullseye. So with daily point goals, you can see each of these kind of has a goal zone, this green area. And so there are primary staff members that see students every day, all day. So they're going to be giving out the most amount of points because they are going to see the most students. Our secondary members, those are going to be people that see students very intermittently. So those might be our administrators, people that are specialists in your school, maybe your speech teacher, that kind of staff member, or your paraprofessionals. And then we also can do this for students. And so we can set a goal for them in this green zone that's their target zone to get their points every day. And if you need an idea or a suggestion how to calculate these points, you're just going to click on this blue button that says need a suggestion, and it's a calculator. So you put in how many students you have about in each class, how many classes you see a day, and then kind of the percentage that you want to go above and below. We usually say about 20%, and then it gives you that goal number. Now, if that number is really high, maybe at the beginning of the year, you might want to scale that back a little bit and then build your staff up to that number, depending on what the number is. So we really want to make those attainable goals and then give your staff maybe a challenge. We know everybody kind of likes a challenge. And so this is a great way to do that for different staff members and also for our students. We want to remind you on that very first page over on the right-hand side, there's always going to be a section that says news and notes that gives you all the important updates of what is happening with PBIS rewards. So don't miss that, along with one of our new favorite things, which is the show me how button. If you forget how to do something in the system, click this show me how, and it will walk you through how to do anything. So if you don't remember how to do setting up a new group, then click here, create a new group, and it will literally walk you through and click you through each one of those steps. If you don't know how to run a raffle, it will take you through it. It'll walk you through. Even our new SEL features, it will walk you through that as well. And if all else fails, you can always reach out. Our help button is at the very top right, and we're here to help you. So please don't hesitate to utilize that as well.
All right. And Anna, do you mind going back to that previous slide real fast?
Oh, sure.
There was one other thing on there that you may have noticed earlier, maybe not, but do you see at the top there where it says point goal?
Mm-hmm.
Your school does have a point goal set. It will show what the goal is for you right there on that home page or that reward page, okay? So that can show you each day, that's how many points you should be given. You also see right next to it, it says awarded today. So it shows how many points you have given that day. So you can see how close you are to the mark, so to speak. Like we said, if you're kind of low or if you're kind of high, it just really is helpful to have that information for you right there on that homepage. So it's time for us to wrap it up. Well, we want you to know that if after today you're in the system, you can't remember how to reward in the group, you can't remember how to make a new group, no worries. If you go to support.pbisrewards.com, we can help. First of all, there's a plethora of guides. There's a plethora of videos. You can even click on where it says learn, and you can go to what we call the Explore series, click on any of those planets, see different steps on how to work things in particular areas. And the great thing is, after you read through the information, you then can actually type in for PD credit for even just looking at that information. Another thing that you can do is if you look at on the home page of the support page at the very bottom right, you can click there to start a chat with someone on our support team. I mean, I'm just going to brag on them. I think that they are the best support team in the world, and they will chat with you right then and there. If you look even below that button, you can see a phone number to get in contact with our support team, as well as an email if you wanted to email them. So please remember, you are not alone in this. You can, of course, look at the recording that's going to be sent to you and use the resources that we send. But if you truly do need some help with something within the PBIS reward system, do not hesitate to go to our support page. It's there for you 24/7. Oh, and thank you, Nicole, so much for the shout out in the chat. We have so enjoyed working with you all today, too. And another thing we want to do is we want to see you again. Okay, please don't let this be the only time that we're going to see you. There's a couple more PD or professional development opportunities coming up. One of them that we love is the expedition, because we get to be together, y'all, for 3 days virtually. Okay. But that one is $95, but we love you all so much that we want to give you personally a $25 off coupon code that you can use right now. So you can get $25 off that $95 to be able to attend the training with us. The way that it works is we have a live Zoom in the morning around 9 Central Time. We have another one in the afternoon around 2 Central Time. In the middle, you're working on modules that you can choose the pace, okay? So that means you don't have to take off work for the 3 days. You basically just want to make sure that you're available for those live Zooms. And then we give you a total of 10 days to get those modules done. And when you are completed, you have 12 professional development hours and a certificate to show that you can use to go towards your licensing or anything else. We definitely want to make you know, we want to spend more time with you. So if you can, please come to our expedition. And if any of you have been to an expedition, would you raise your hand either virtually or put your camera on and raise your hand? We would love to see if some of you have already been in the expeditions with us.
Oh, okay. Hey.
Yay, all right. That's wonderful. And so the other thing is, if you still want to do those modules, but maybe you don't need the live sessions, then you can do the voyage. The voyage is pretty much most of the same modules that you do as part of the expedition, but without the live Zooms. And you can start it whenever you want, and you have 14 days to get it done once you start. And that's only $25. So these are two training, you know, opportunities that we think if you want to go deeper with PBIS and PBIS Rewards, these are definitely two options. We also have some more free trainings coming up in our Blitz. So what we're going to do is we're going to put a link in the chat box for you to be able to see the links to the expedition, the voyage, and as well, the training blitz calendar, where pretty much almost all of the sessions on there are free. So we'll put those links in the chat box for you. And we also want to make sure, like we said earlier today, we want to personally invite you to our Facebook user group. We call it the break room. And we would love for you to be there with us. We often use that group to give us great ideas. We use that group to get feedback. We give away prizes. We have freebie Fridays. So if you're not a part of our user group, this is your personal invitation to join. You can use your phone or smart device and you can just scan the QR code, or we'll also put in the chat box the link for you to get into the user group. We'd love to have you. This is your personal invitation. And then here it is, drum roll please, y'all. Here's that resource link, okay? So this has all the things we showed. It's got those matrix samples. It's got the virtual behaviors chart that Anna went through. It's got some other goodies. It's got, you know, other recordings, other things all on this resource page. So please, 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 this will be emailed to you if you did register for today, along with the recording will be emailed to you. But if you did not register for today's session, you definitely want to click on this link so you can get all of these resources, okay? So we're going to put that into the chat box for you. Click on it right now, guys, so you have access to all of the great resources from today's session. Okay?
All right, and then we just want to say thank you to everybody. This is our last QR code. If you will scan this, this is our survey. It's really short. It has about 7 questions on it, and it just helps us know how you think we did, what we can do to make this one better. This is our first time to do this training, and we have another one on Wednesday that is focused on rewarding. And I think India, is that one at 1 o'clock Central Time?
Yes.
I think that seems right.
Mm-hmm.
So we are going to...
No, I'm sorry. It's at 11 this Wednesday.
11, okay. Central Time.
Redeeming one? Yeah, 11 Central Time.
Okay, sorry. Thank you. So we are really looking forward to that one as well. It'll be the next piece. And then we're also going to have a piece of this training series is just for administrators on what to do with PBIS Rewards once you get started with that on the administrative side. So we'll kind of go deeper into the settings and those kinds of things. So those are some of our upcoming trainings. So we really appreciate everybody being here. We can hang on a couple of minutes if you have some questions. But other than that, our resources will be up there and available for you very soon. And we will make the presentation and the recording available to you as well. But we appreciate everybody being here today. Is there anything we can help with?